Good morning, children. As I promised you, we are going to have a lesson, our first lesson. The name of the lesson is Along the Yellow Brick Road. And this lesson is based on fantasy story. Do you know what is fantasy? Fantasy means which is not in reality. It is in imagination, like fairy tales and Aladdin's genie, Aladdin's magic lamp, okay, flying carpet, and so on. Unicorn, I can tell. Such so many things, unusual things, which are not common. We don't know about them in reality, just in imagination. Where do you find these things? In fantasy stories. Your comics books, understand, or in your Cartoon Network shows, okay? Many such things you find in these things. So such a one such story we have here. It is Along the Yellow Brick Road. This story is about a girl, a scarecrow, and a tin man. You know, girl, she is life. Okay, she goes into she enters one fantasy world. There she meets a scarecrow and a tin man. You know what is scarecrow? Scarecrow is the one which is kept in the field to scare away the crows or any birds. Scare away means to drive away. Seeing that object, the birds feel afraid and they don't come and spoil the crops. How it is made is, one pole will be there, and on the pole, they will fix the sticks like hands, and upper, there will be an earthen pot. Like this, and all features of human being will be made to it like this, understand, and shirt, clothes will be put up on this object. It is called scarecrow. Okay, it is called scarecrow. Why it is kept in the field? To scare away. Scare means drive away, to make the birds afraid of this object in the field. Okay, so one scarecrow, tin man, a man made of tin. His body was fully rusted, he couldn't move. Then this girl helps the man, so tin man, to smoothen his body parts. This is the story we have. Let us know about it. I am going to read and explain you. And you know one thing, from 5th you are going to get the books from Sri Vidya Shop, children. From 5th onwards, books are available in Sri Vidya Shop. Please buy the book so that when I am reading the lesson and all, you can keep your book open and see it. That's why you need the book. Please do buy the textbooks. So now our lesson begins. This piece is taken from the book The Wonderful Wizard of Oz by L. Frank Baum. L. Frank Baum is the name of the writer. Understand? It is a tale, story of wizard, wonderful wizard. Then, it is a story about a young girl called Dorothy who is carried away by a storm to the magical land of Oz. Oz land, imaginary world it is. One day, this girl was carried away by the strong storm. You know what is storm? Very strong wind which lifts away all the dust particles, paper pieces, and even it uproots the trees. speed wind. That speed wind, what did it do? It took her away to a fantasy land called Land of Oz. There she has many adventures on her journey down the yellow brick road. So when she entered this land of Oz, there she had many adventurous journey. Adventurous means what? Which is full of thrill. You know what is thrill? You feel bravery, you feel as if interesting thing, which is unable to do, you want to do such thing. They are full of thrill. You think you could not do. So for example, you are a fourth class kid, okay? So climbing a big tree is a thrill for you. You, when you look at the tree like that, you feel you can't climb it, but you try to do and you be successful. It is a thrill, adventure for you. Understand? And going into the dark cave, we are afraid actually, but you will dare to do it. Daring to do with the such things which are impossible, which are thought to be impossible, which you think they are impossible, you want to do such things, it is called adventurous activity. So this girl Dorothy also met with so many adventures on her way to the yellow brick road. Along the way she meets some strange new friends. Among them are a talking scarecrow and a tin man. So on her way to the yellow brick road, she meets many strange new friends. Strange means unknown. Strange, peculiar, unknown. Strange means unknown. Whom we don't know, new person. One time also you don't meet. Such people are called strange people. So she meets so many strange friends on her way. Among them, two characters which we have got in this story are Talking Scarecrow and a Tin Man. Talking Scarecrow and a Tin Man. These are the two other characters in our story along the brick road. Who is the first one? Dorothy. Dorothy, a girl who was driven away, taken away by the strong wind to the fantasy land called the Land of Oz. There she meets Talking Scarecrow. Just now I drew it on the blackboard and showed you. And a Tin Man. Okay. So, what she experiences with them? What she do with them? Understand? Or what all the three of them together do is our story. Okay. So one sunny morning, Dorothy and Scarecrow came by a beautiful clear water spring. Dorothy bathed, drank and ate a light breakfast there while Scarecrow looked on thoughtfully. Okay, so while walking, first who were there? Only Talking Scarecrow and Dorothy were moving about. Then one fine morning, bright morning, sunny morning means bright morning, they came to a beautiful water spring. You know, water spring, what do you mean by spring? A small source of water, clear water. Then what did Dorothy do? She bathed. Bathed anakudamma, bathed anali. Bath is different. Took a bath anali. This is bathed. What you should say? Bathed. Bathed means took a bath. and drank water from this clear water spring. Then she had some light breakfast. What did she do? Where did she do? They came by a beautiful, by means beside, by means here beside, pakkana, beside, by means beside. Okay, they came by a beautiful clear water spring. They came beside the spring, water spring. They, what did Dorothy do? She bathed, means she took bath, snanam chestundi. She took bath and she drank water. Then she had some little breakfast, light breakfast. And when she was doing all these things, having breakfast, bathing, drinking water, while she was doing all these things, what did the scarecrow do? Scarecrow just moving about, looking thoughtfully. Thoughtfully means thinking about the things around. Thoughtfully means thinking about the things all around him. Then what happened? Watching her, he said, "I must be troublesome to be made of flesh. You must always worry about where to sleep, eat and drink. However, you also have brains, and it must be wonderful to be able to think properly." So, watching her means whom watching? Who? Scarecrow was watching Dorothy doing all these things, all the activities. What activities? Drinking water, bathing, eating breakfast, etc. While looking at her, seeing her, watching her means seeing her, he said, "It must be troublesome to be made of flesh." We human beings are made of flesh, no, only bones. Do you have? On the bone we have a cover, layer of all flesh. Can you see any bones here? No. Why? Because on the bone we have flesh covering. On the flesh covering, we have covering of skin on our body. That's why we can't see the bones. So, here, what she said? What he thought? Being made of flesh is troublesome. Means difficult thing. It is difficult to carry such a body which is made of flesh. Who thought like this? Scarecrow. Why? Because you must always, anywhere you can't lie down. Scarecrow, it was made of wooden sticks and a pole and a pot. So that it need not worry about where to sleep, where to lie down or where to sit. Being human beings, as we have the body which is made of bones and flesh. Here what we have to do, we have to think. Can you sleep anywhere on the road? No, we can't. Rough surface, we can't. Where do you usually sleep? In your bedroom, on a soft bed, right? Some people on a floor, spreading the carpet and all, we sleep. But we can't sleep on a floor just like that, anywhere. In the ground, on muddy land, in the field, we can't sleep like that, yes? So, Scarecrow says, it is very troublesome to carry such a body. Which body? The body made of flesh and bones. Whose body is made of flesh and bone? Human beings. Dorothy's body. Why? Because she has to think, always worry about where to sleep, what to eat, what to drink, etc. Understand? Whether to drink water from such a pond, whether water is clean and clear or not, everything we have to think. We can't eat anything we get. We can't drink anything we get. That's why it is very troublesome thing, difficult thing for the human beings to carry on their body. But what is one plus point, positive thing, good thing among? We have brain. What we have? We have brain to think. Understand? This is a wonderful gift of God to human being. We have brain to think. Who says scarecrow says? But it is very wonderful to have a brain so that you can think properly. You can think what is right and what is wrong. Okay. Dorothy smiled and was about to reply when suddenly she heard a deep groan from somewhere nearby. So, when the scarecrow was discussing all these things about human body, who he was discussing with? Dorothy. Dorothy was about to answer to him. She wanted to discuss on this topic with the scarecrow. But suddenly she heard some groan. Groan means painful voice. Amma, oh God. Like this, when you have fever or any body pains or you fall down, you groan. Groan. G-R-O-A-N. Groan. Groan means what you tell in Telugu? Mulgadamantara, I want to tell you. Amma, oh God, anything, pains, you say like that. That is called groaning. She could hear some groan, sound of painful sound from somewhere in the nearby forest. What was that? She asked, surprised. Surprising, what was that? She asked, scarecrow. I don't know, but we can go and see. Said the scarecrow. I don't know what it is. Let us go and see who or what it is. Soon they heard another groan. The sound seemed to come from behind. They walked towards the forest and suddenly discovered something shining in the sunlight between the trees. They came closer to the spot and found it was a man made entirely of tin with an axe in his hand. His head, arms and legs were fitted to the body. So soon they moved from where they heard the groan from behind, backside of them. So they turned back and went into the forest. Understand? What they found there, they discovered. Suddenly they discovered. Discovered means found. Discovered means what, children? Found. Discovered means found. What they found there? They found something shining between the tree branches. Something was shining there because of sunlight. They came closer. Close means not mutapettadamu, moosiveyadamu. Closing means close and take near. Closer means nearer. They came nearer to the object which was shining. To the spot and found it was a man made entirely of tin. They came nearer to the spot. Spot means place. Spot means place. They came to the place where that shining object was kept. What was it? It was a man entirely made of tin. Entirely means completely. Entirely means completely made of tin with an axe in his hand. Axe, you know what is axe? Which we use for cutting the trees. It will be like this. Somewhat like this it will be. Okay. Here it is a wooden stick will be there. Here it is iron object. We call it axe. Goddari and taro e mumitandla. Okay. He held it. His head, arms, legs, all were fitted to his body with screws. Why? Because it was a tin man. It was entirely completely made of tin. Tin ante telusa denkantaru meeru inumu antaru chudandi inma sheet. Tin sheet tho chesina manishi aakaram untundi adi ante bomma laga. And its hands, legs were fitted to its body with screws. But he stood as if he could not stir at all. Stir means move. S-T-I-R, stir means move. Stir, stir anakandi. This is stir. Stir means move. He stood as if he couldn't stir at all. He can't move at all. Dorothy and Scarecrow looked at him amazed. Amazed means surprised. Amazed means surprised. They looked at the man amazed, surprised. So it was you who was groaning, exclaimed Dorothy. So it was you who was groaning, exclaimed. Surprisingly, Dorothy asked that man. So it was you who was groaning. Yes, cried the tin man. Yes, he cried. I have been groaning for more than a year now. Not today. I have been groaning continuously more than a year. Since 1 year, I am just going on groaning like this. But no one has heard me or came to me to help. He said, I have been groaning. I have been groaning in pain. Since 1 year, but nobody came to take care of me or help me. What can I do for you? Dorothy asked softly, for she was moved by his sad voice. Mood means felt sad. Mood. Moving means not moving like this, like this. Mood means felt bad for his sad condition. Okay. So, she asked, what can I do for you? You don't say, what can I do for you? It is not a statement, not a sentence, it's a question. How can you ask a question? What's your name? Where are you going? What can I do for you? Means, what help can I do for you? She asked. You could get an oil can and oil my joints. What joints? Where the body parts were fitted. Hands, arms, legs, etc. You bring oil and oil my joints. Put oil into my joints. You have bicycle, no children? You will have to oil it to make it smooth near its chain and wheels. You could get an oil and oil my joints, answered Tin Man. They are rusted so badly, I can't move them at all. If I am well oiled, I shall be all right again. So, because my body parts are rusted, joints are rusted. Rusted ante tukku pattadam. Iron ki manamu water moisture pette, water tagilte, oka orange color object form avutundi dani meeda. That is called rust. So my body parts are rusted. For a long time nobody oiled my body parts. So please get some oil and oil my body, said the tin man. If you oil my body parts, I shall be all right again. And where from she has to get? She did not have any oil with her. So tin man pointed to a hut. Pointed means showed a hut where the oil can was kept. He pointed to a hut at the edge of the forest. He pointed to a hut at the edge of the forest and added, you will find an oil can on my cottage shelf. He showed, okay, see there in that cottage on the shelf you can find an oil can. So, Dorothy rushed off immediately. Immediately means very quickly. Rushed off means ran to the hut, because she is very kind enough. So she came back shortly, means very quickly she came back and brought the oil can. Then she asked, where should I start? Oil my neck first. Neck is joined, no, with tin screws. You oil my neck first, said the tin man. As Dorothy began oiling it, Scarecrow held his tin head and moved it gently from side to side till it worked freely. So while Dorothy was oiling the neck, for example, the tin man, Scarecrow was moving his head slowly like this, so that smoothly it started to move. Tin man now gave a sigh of relief. Ammaya, ani relief ga cheppadu endukante all his body parts started moving freely as Dorothy oiled the joints. This is a great comfort, he said. It is very good for me now. I am feeling smooth. After this, if you oil the joints of my legs, I shall be able to walk again. So he said, you can join my shoulders, hands and legs also, so that I can walk. So Dorothy and Scarecrow oiled his legs till they moved easily. So after they oiled, they started to move easily and freely. The man felt grateful and politely thanked them for their help. I must have stood here forever if you had not come along, he said. So you certainly have saved my life. How did you happen to hear? See, so if anybody helps us, we should say thanks, no? Grateful. Grateful means we have to be thankful to them. And politely we should say thank you. Understand, whoever it is. So he thanked them and felt grateful. And he said, if you have not come here, I would have not moved at all. You saved my life. How could you come here? He asked. What Dorothy says, tomorrow we will continue in our lesson. What we learnt? We learnt today three characters in the lesson. Dorothy, Scarecrow, Talking Scarecrow and a Tin Man. Understand? How could Dorothy meet them? One day, a strong wind pushed her away into a fantasy land called Land of Oz. There, she had lot of adventures and she met with many characters, many friends, strange friends, unknown friends, who are not common like us. Such uncommon friends she met, and there she had lot of adventure, and we are going to have a lesson about that adventure. Yeah, what we learned? She met a Scarecrow, both of them came to a water spring. There she had bath, had her breakfast and drank water. Seeing this, Scarecrow thought, a human's body is very difficult to carry because we have to think where to sleep and all. But one positive thing, one good thing with human body is we have brain to think rightly, properly. While they were coming, when the Scarecrow was discussing all this, they could hear one groan, painful voice, sound. Then they came to the forest, they found the Tin Man, and the Tin Man's body parts were joined and they were rested. Then the Tin Man requested Dorothy to oil the body parts, and she did it, and his body parts got smoothened so that he can move freely. And he asked the reason for coming here to Dorothy. And Dorothy, what Dorothy answers, let us see in our next lesson tomorrow. Okay? Thank you, children. That's all for today.